pothos plants love climbing up moss poles. Been there, done that, got bored. So 18 months ago, I got this crazy idea to create a pothos moss wall. Not a moss pole, a moss wall. So I decided to use some cuttings from my Snow Queen pothos. Excuse me, this plant is not called a Snow Queen, it's called an Enjoy. Hold on to your knickers and calm down. I know that in some of your countries, this is called an Enjoy, but in Australia, it's called a Snow Queen. Some of you might be wondering, what the heck is a moss wall? When I bit my moss wall, it was really small. I was working with only a few cuttings. Today, this is what she looks like. I know you have many questions and I will get to them. But before I answer your questions, I've got one more thing to show you. I did another thing. 6 months after I made my Snow Queen moss wall, I decided I was gonna make another moss wall, only designed differently this time and filled with syngoniums. This is my syngonium moss wall. It is absolutely insane, right? I know you're dying to get close-ups and I know you've got even more questions after seeing this syngonium moss wall. So we'll jump straight into the Q&A and I'll tell you what my plans are for these two babies behind me. Do you have any mold or fungus gnats issues? I haven't had any mold issues with my moss walls and I'm putting that squarely at the feet of the fact that we have very good quality sphagnum moss here in Australia. We're really lucky in that way, easily accessible. I haven't had any issues with that at all. But another thing is I keep my moss walls in very well ventilated areas with a lot of air. If I see that there isn't great airflow, I've got a fan going, so there is just no chance for that mold to take a hold in my moss walls. Fungus gnats, no, I have not seen a fungus gnat issue at all. Bearing in mind though, I do grow my moss walls in Lekka, so obviously that helps a lot. So I just generally don't have fungus gnats anywhere in my home because all my plants are living in Lekka. Next question, how do you water your moss walls? I generally like to use my high pressure sprayer when I'm watering these just to get that moisture on the sphagnum moss initially, and then I will basically use my watering can to get more of the nutrient solution down through the moss. Or in case of the syngonium moss wall, this is actually a sphagnum moss and tree fern fiber combo moss wall. So, and it's so much, this one is so much easier to keep moist than the Snow Queen moss wall because this one is purely sphagnum moss. And when I do let that dry out a little bit more than I would like, it's a lot harder to get this one going. On the days when I'm feeling particularly frisky or I want to flush the pots because they're living in Lekka, I will take both these moss walls outside and I will hose them down with my hose, and that just gets that moss wall very, very easily watered. Are you going to chop and extend or just extend? To be honest with you, I'm not too sure what I'm gonna do because as you can see, the syngonium one has actually reached the top of the pole. This one over here, you can see that is my batik. My syngonium batik has just reached the top of that wall, and the panda, oh my gosh, that panda has just gone insane. And the thickness of that stem is just to die for. Look at that. It is just absolutely beautiful. I would like to extend this one, to be honest with you. Why? Just because I can, I think. I would really love to see how I can actually keep it stable in there. The good thing with this particular one is, I'll turn it around so you can see the design of the syngonium moss wall. It's actually got a plastic sheet back design, and it's got these three metal cables running through at the back to provide the stability. So I think I am going to get, I'm gonna make another one exactly like this, put it at the top and attach it to this one somehow with lots and lots of cable ties, I think. And then I'm going to get three very, very long metal rods. So maybe about 1.5 meters high to go all the way up. And I'll put that on top and extend it that way because I just want to see what would happen with this. Can you just imagine this being a massive, massive block of syngoniums everywhere? I'm really, really curious. So I think I might extend this one. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with this one. I think I won't. I won't extend this one. I'll probably just let them grow all the way to the top and then I'll bring them back down again because yeah, I can't really be bothered. And this one was my very first moss wall. There are many things I could do to improve on this one, so I'm not particularly attached to it. I could even, I don't know. I mean, I'm actually thinking I might just give it away. I don't know, I might do a giveaway. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. Those of you guys who are watching from Australia, would you be interested in winning that in a giveaway? That might be something I might consider doing because I'm planning on something bigger, extending and trailing down. So no chopping involved in this. It would be way too problematic. What would you change to make it more efficient? Would you consider a plastic back of some sort, or is it perfect as it is? So I think the person who sent me this question was not aware that I actually put a plastic back on the Syngonium one. So I made the Snow Queen moss wall first, and back then I really wasn't so much into the plastic back thing. And then when I really got into that, I thought I'll revamp the wall and make it a plastic sheet back wall, which I did with the Syngoniums. So plastic is really great because it actually helps keep that moisture in that wall. One of the things that I would do is actually use a much sturdier piece of plastic. You can see that it's quite floppy. It's not as firm as I would like it to be. It works well when you're making a moss pole because it's not as wide, so it's easier to maintain the stability. But when it's wide like this, it does tend to get a little bit floppy. And that's why I have three of those metal rods providing support. But maybe a thing to do is get a sturdier piece of plastic. So maybe some guttering or something like that. I'm still looking into that because I'm not very handy. I don't quite know what's out there. So if you guys have any ideas of what I can use that is a bit sturdier than this, let me know in the comments below because I'm dying to recreate this, but with better materials. The next thing I would do to make this better is I would actually use a bigger pot. Yep. So this one is a Lechuza. I think this is a Balconera 50. I'm looking for something with a lot more depth, something that's a little bit like a trough. And the reason I want that is I want to be able to put the moss wall further, deeper into the pot, and in that way, providing more stability. So with these ones, because the pot is quite shallow, a lot of it can be a bit wobbly, and I know some people have told me that they've tried to recreate this and it's toppled over. So I think if you go deeper, that might work better. Another thing I would do is actually make this as tall as I want it to be right from the very beginning. Having the end goal in mind and not having to start doing these additions halfway through is certainly a better way to do it than this. Definitely to make the moss wall out of a mixture of sphagnum moss and tree fern fiber instead of just the sphagnum moss that I used when making the Snow Queen. It's so much easier to keep the Syngonium moss wall moist than it is to keep the Snow Queen moist. So having that combination is really fantastic. And the only reason I would be combining tree fern fiber and sphagnum moss and not just using tree fern fiber alone is tree fern fiber is quite a lot more particulate. So you do tend to have the tree fern fiber seeping through the little holes of the mesh that I use to create that wall, and it can be a little bit annoying because it goes on my leaves, it goes into my lecker. When I use the sphagnum moss, it keeps it in place. So having the combination of tree fern fiber that holds onto that moisture so well without that hydrophobic properties that sphagnum moss has, putting these two things together makes a formidable moss wall. The next thing I would like to do is use a water pump. So I'd get a small water pump, have it sit at the bottom of my trough, and that's where a trough comes in as well. When you have something a lot bigger, you can put a water pump in there, put a water pump, have some cabling running through the back, right? And maybe coming out at certain points, maybe at the top and maybe halfway or something. And that's going to be pulling the nutrient solution from the bottom, going into the moss wall and basically create a self-watering moss wall. So I won't have to worry about watering that moss ball at all. It's always going to be moist because as long as that pump is running, that moss is always going to be moist, which is going to be superb. I cannot wait to try this. It's going to be absolutely epic. Next time I'm going to make something like this, I want to make it in a very dedicated spot of my home. So I'm going to find a wall that is basically doing nothing, and I am going to create this thing. So I'm going to have the trough. I'm going to have the moss wall going up the wall. I'm going to have those pumps that are pumping that water straight onto the moss wall. But I will also attach some grow lights. So I will have some dedicated grow lights that are probably going to be at the top somewhere, shining down onto my plant, and just, oh my goodness, can you imagine? Those leaves are getting huge and it's also got light, nothing to do but grow. That's gonna be my moss wall 3.0. How are they secured in the pot? The first thing I will say is, if you haven't seen the videos where I create these masterpieces, I highly recommend that you go and watch them, because that'll give you a better sense of what it is that I'm trying to explain. But what I did do when I was creating these is at the bottom, so if you look at, I don't know if I'll be able to do that. Oh, so when I pick that up, that's an insert, right? I actually created some holes at the bottom of the inside pot, and these metal rods went through those holes, and that sort of created that anchor. So it looks like they're suspended midair, but they're actually encased within this net pot inside there. But probably what would have been a good thing to do as well is maybe to create some holes at the top of the net pot. So right there at the top, and get some cable ties and attach it to that. So if you can see, it leans a bit forward, but if I put those cable ties and pull it back like that, then that's a lot straighter. That's definitely something that is possible to do. Question is, do I buy my moss in bulk online? Thankfully, no, I don't have to buy my moss in bulk online. I spend way too much on sphagnum moss. I'm not doing that anymore because I'm trying to reduce the number of moss poles I've got. But we're really, really lucky in Australia. You just walk into any Bunnings and you can find 500 grams of sphagnum moss or 100 grams of sphagnum moss. Not the cheapest, but not prohibitively expensive as well. So it's something that's readily available to us in Australia. All you need to do is get up, get in the car, go to Bunnings, and you can have some sphagnum moss. What I do buy online though is tree fern fiber. I'm not moving house anytime soon, and I'd really love to get stuck into my moss wall 3.0 version on a dedicated wall in my home with some fantastic grow lights, as I've described. Please let me know in the comments below how you think I should design my next moss wall, the moss wall 3.0. Let me know all your crazy ideas. The crazier, the better. I want to know what they are because I want to do this thing. If you haven't seen how I created these two babies, go and watch these two videos, see how I created them. Let me know in the comments below how I could have done a better job. I'll see you there.